Dear learners, greetings of the day. Today we are going to discuss what is orientation, what is induction. Orientation or induction is also called onboarding. Orientation is designed to provide new hires with the information they need to work in the organization comfortably. Induction is a planned introduction to the freshers, to their jobs, to their peers, and to their company. To understand each and every aspect of induction, let us go to the slides. And before that, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe. And if you like the video, please like and share with your friends. So let's move to the slides. Let us understand first where this induction or orientation function is placed in the activities of human resource management. The induction function is immediately followed after the end of the selection process and the acceptance of job offer by the candidate. Potential is not equal to the performance. Even high potential employees cannot perform if they do not know what to do or how to do it. Thus, all organizations have some type of formal or informal induction program. Especially when they first join the organization, they are supposed to be familiarized with the people around, with the processes around, and in whole with the organization. I have shared a definition on the screen with you. The definition says, organization is designed to provide a new employee with the information he needs to function comfortably and effectively in the organization. It means that the organization is trying to make the employee comfortable in the organization once he joins. And to make him comfortable, he is being familiarized with the organization. So broadly, we can divide this information into three parts. First is general information about the daily work routine in the company. Second, a review of the company's history, founding fathers, objectives, operations, products and services, and how the employee's job contributes to the achievement of the goal of the organization. How organization needs an employee. Third kind of information that is to be provided to the employee is detailed presentation of the organization's policies, work rules, and employee benefit. This is to be shared with him. Let us go through the definition given by the scholar Michael Armstrong. He says, induction is the process of receiving and welcoming employees when they first join in a company and giving them the basic information they need to settle down quickly and happily and start working in the organization. Another scholar, Donald Curry, says, induction is a process through which new employees, probably on joining, are introduced to the organization in the broad context. Then he lists what kind of information or what kind of introduction about the organization is to be given to the employees. Organization's culture, work rules and procedures. Then in the local context where they meet their new colleagues. This is how Donald Curry explains the orientation. So we can say that orientation is a process through which the new employee is being made comfortable in the organization. And now, what is the organization's role in this orientation program? We'll try to understand this with the help of four steps. Assessment and the determination of induction program content, designing the induction program, implementing the induction program, evaluating induction program's effectiveness. Let's see how these four steps are to be applied by the HR managers in an organization. First is assessment and the determination of induction program content. As you can see from the slide, topics covered in induction are, first, organizational issues. These can be history of the company, these can be names and titles of key executives, these can be employees' title and department, these can be layouts of physical facilities, where the restrooms are, where the canteen is, where his own office is, where is the office of his boss. Then probationary period. Though it is normally mentioned in the offer period, but it is always good to mention it again during the induction period. Then products and services offered by the company. Overview of the processes and procedures in the company, how what works, then what kind of disciplinary procedures are followed by the company. Some companies have an employee handbook. The handbook is also given to the employees at the time of induction. Then some safety steps which are good for the safety of the employee, they are to be detailed. Mission statement of the company is given to them. Goals of the organization are shared with them. The strategies that the organization follows, they are to be shared with the employees. And organizational chart is going to tell them where do they stand in the organization. So organization chart is also shared during the induction program with the employees. In the second step, they are now being introduced to the people around. And these people are their supervisors, their co-workers, their trainers, and at times employee counselors also. Then comes the most important information, because this is about the benefits that are there in the company for an employee. And this is going to make them more comfortable in the organization. They can be told about the pay scale, vacations, holidays, about rest pauses, which are given during the whole day's work, training avenues, then counseling areas. They can be told about insurances, medical and retirement benefits. After making them comfortable, now it is the time that they can be told about the duties they have to perform. They can be told about the job location, job tasks, and job safety needs. For example, if they are supposed to work on a machine, all the safety measures that they need to take should be made clear right from the beginning. And induction program is the best time to share this information with them. Overview of all the jobs in the organization should be given to them. Objectives of all the jobs, or at least their jobs, should also be shared with the employees. Relationship of their job with other jobs in the organization. This is also to be made clear at the time of induction. Then they should be introduced with the work environment. First comes physical layout of the workplace. What stands where? What is needed for what? This kind of information is to be shared with the employee. Then workflow, that means sequence or steps of the process, are to be shared with these new employees. Coordination between these steps, coordination between different jobs, coordination between different processes, this is also to be shared with the employee. Then where do the supplies come from? Location of supplies is shared with the employee. Facilities like restroom, facilities like their canteens, food areas or emergency exits. This is also to be shared. You can share with them what kind of dress code are they supposed to follow in the organization. If you have a uniform, that is to be given, and it is to be shared that they are supposed to wear the uniform while on duty. If there is no uniform and your organization wants them to come in the formals, then this is also to be made clear. Second phase is designing the induction program. Now, this responsibility of designing the induction program also lies on the shoulders of the HR manager. What kind of interactions will be there during the program? What should be the length of the induction program? Whether this is just a half day program or a full day program or maybe 15 days induction program? All this is to be decided before the induction program starts. And who's going to conduct this induction program? Whether the immediate supervisor or the boss or somebody else? This has to be decided beforehand. What will be the procedure of induction? What will be the levels of induction? And what type of induction program this is going to be? Formal, informal, structured, unstructured? This way, the HR manager has to plan for the induction program. Then what kind of methods will be used? What media will be used? And what will be other steps which are required for an effective induction program? After this comes the third step. Implementing the induction program. Whatever has been planned, that must be perfect. A perfect planning is there for the induction program, and now is the time of implementation. At the time of induction program, welcome to the organization is the first step. Second is to explain about the company, deliver all the informations that we have just discussed, and let them know about the rules and explain who's who and clarify doubts if any. This is the main implementation stage of an induction program. While implementing the induction program, you need to be a little careful. You have to decide how to make it a classy program. And after this, you can take the employee for a tour of the building. And this is going to help them hit the ground running. So try to make it fun for the employees so that they start enjoying their job right from the first day. But there are a few cautions in this phase of implementation. The HR manager has to be very careful whether he is using too much valuable orientation time to complete the paperwork only, or is he giving too much information too quickly to the employees, or maybe irrelevant information is being shared. If irrelevant information is shared with the employee, then the employee will be left with many doubts and confusions. And this is not the purpose of a good induction program. You need more cautions while implementing an orientation program. You are not supposed to scare the employees. Scaring the employees by spending an inordinate amount of time discussing the negative aspects of the job, or using lectures and videos rather than methods that allow for two-way communication, because one-way communication is not good for any induction program. If you do not have questions from the employees, maybe the doubts will remain unanswered there in their minds. Any orientation program should not be limited to only the first day at work, because the employee may need more than one day to get adjusted to the new environment of the company. And make sure that you do not start selling your organization on the very first day. With all these cautions, while implementing an orientation program, we can expect that a good orientation program will make the new employee comfortable in the organization. And next phase from the organization side is evaluating the orientation program. And you know, Gary Dessler has given us a very interesting statement. Let me read it out, the statement for you. Not all new hires react to the orientation in the same way. It means that the same induction program may have different value for different employees. The supervisor should be vigilant and follow up and encourage the employees and to keep them engaged in those activities that will enable each to learn the ropes and quickly become productive, because this is the objective of an induction program, to make the employee productive as soon as possible in the organization. And for this evaluation, you will need the feedback. How to obtain the feedback now? The feedback can be obtained with the help of feedback forms, which can be given to the employees, and the employees can be instructed to fill the information in the form. You can use roundtable discussions to obtain this feedback, or in-depth interviews. Of course, they come after a few days or maybe after a few months. Or you can use questionnaires. With the help of your questions, you can collect the information that you need for the evaluation of the induction program. Now we will discuss the objectives of an induction program. First objective is to smooth the preliminary stages, where everything is likely to be strange and unfamiliar to the new employee. Second objective can be to establish quickly a favorable attitude to the company in the mind of the new employee, so that he is more likely to stay. An orientation program also assists the new employee in acquiring appropriate role behavior. Next objective can be to obtain effective output from the new employee in the shortest possible time. It also reduces the likelihood of the employees leaving quickly. And to provide new employees with the basic background information they need to work in the company, an orientation program also fosters self-directed behavior. That means the employee is in a position to take the decisions in the organization himself or herself. A good orientation program also reduces the initial anxiety and stress of the new joinee. True. Because we are trying to make him get adjusted to the new environment. This also familiarizes the new employees with the job, people, workplace, work environment, and the organization. The program also provides an opportunity to interact with other fellow employees. It creates proper awareness in the minds of the new employees. This also reduces the chances of exploitation by the co-workers and reduces turnover and startup costs, reduces the time it takes for the newcomer to reach the highest level of proficiency in the organization, assists the newcomer in learning the organization's value, culture, and expectations from the employee. Next objective can be to help the newcomer to get adjusted in the work groups and its norms. It also eases the burden of socializing newcomers for supervisors and co-workers. In fact, it provides favorable initial job experiences and clarifies any doubts in the mind of the new joinee. It also reduces the cultural shock that any new joinee may get, because maybe the organizational culture in which he or she has worked previously was entirely different from the culture of your organization. So he may get some shocks. A good orientation program is to be designed in such a manner that the shock of this new culture is reduced for the employee. This induction program generally takes three phases to get completed. First phase, where the human resource manager is active, he plays the role of introducing this new staff member to the personnel unit and other people of the organization. In the second phase, the immediate superior may take up this responsibility, because in the first phase he was introduced to the immediate boss, the immediate superior, and now this immediate superior will perform the induction program for the new joinee. And this way the induction program may be over, but the third phase, where the follow-up is to be taken, which may come after a few weeks, that is also an important phase for the induction program. Very quickly, we will revise what are the requisites of an effective induction program. Warm welcome, relevant information, right pace, you should not be too hasty in giving the information, and the speed of the information that is being given to the employee should not be too slow either. help and encouragement to get involved in the work. Then trained supervisor is a prerequisite. You are supposed to make sure that no superficial or false information is shared with the employee so that the trust is built. And sufficient time is to be given in the induction program. But even then, there can be problems with induction programs. So let's see what kind of problems can be there in an induction program. First is, too much information can be given to the newcomer, which he or she may not be able to absorb. And there may be too much emphasis on paperwork during the induction program, which may make the induction program boring or burdensome for the new employee. Or irrelevant information can be shared with the employee. This acts as a problem. And at times, supervisors have a typical psychology. They can use scary tactics when the responsibility comes to them of introducing the new joinee with the staff, with the work rules, etc. Maybe they portray a horrified picture of the work. This is a problem for the induction program. If it is too formal, then there is only one-way communication. And the questions in the mind of the new joinee will not be answered, which is a problem for the orientation program. And at times, the supervisors have just one shot mentality. Whatever is to be shared, share it right now. And this approach is not good for the induction. At times, the supervisors are not even trained for the induction program. They are trained for the technical jobs that they do in the company, but not for induction. And at times, the newcomer is sent to the workplace or thrown into action very soon. The employee does not get enough time to get acquainted with the job. At times, supervisor is too busy for an induction program. Again, a problem. And a busy supervisor just gives a sketchy information about the job and pushes the employee into the job. At times, supervisors consider this induction program an extra workload for them, which leads to lack of interest in the induction program at the side of the supervisor. Some supervisors consider this induction program as a small and unimportant job for them. And even if these problems are not existing, lack of follow-up becomes the biggest problem, because then the area of improvement for future induction programs is blocked. And this is a problem for the induction program itself and a problem for the future induction programs as well. You can see the names of the reference books which have been used to prepare this video. For further reading, you can consult these books. Thank you. Wish you all the best. Bye-bye.